of 10 Cats Does Countdown. Alan Carr. Jonathan Ross. Harriet Kemsley. Maisie Adams. Huge Davies. Susie Dent. Rachel Riley. And your host, Jimmy Carr.
Hello and welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, a show about letters, numbers and conundrums. OK, let's meet tonight's players. First up, it's guest team captain Jonathan Ross.
Hello, everyone.
Jonathan has a very unique look. I like to describe it as the bloated corpse of Lawrence Llewellyn Bone.
I'll be honest with you, I think that's quite fair.
You look amazing this evening, I've got to say.
Why are you saying that now, you prick? A minute ago... you're saying I was looking like a dead has-been decorator, and now you're saying I look amazing.
Can we see the full outfit? Because the full outfit
is
everything.
Yes, there, it's got this.
The shoes.
And then
the shoes
are everything. And then wait till you see my pants. You won't believe it. I got this from my tailor in Indonesia. Yeah, no, well, he's not really my tailor. He's a bloke on Etsy, but he's in Indonesia.
Have you ever met this man?
No. What if he didn't like me? Or what if I didn't
like him? Well, he clearly doesn't like you. Look what he makes.
And Jonathan's teammate, Maisie Adams.
Yeah.
Maisie graduated with a BA in acting and community theatre, so we'd better get a move on before NASA call and snap her up. Up against them this evening, it's guest team captain Alan Carr.
Yeah.
Alan's first ever acting role was as Squealer the Pig in Animal Farm. It's great, Alan, but you can stop doing the voice now.
Yeah, so I was a pig. I had these pig head like this, and I had these sticks, and I burst in the room to show me mum and dad, and the dog shat itself.
And joining Alan tonight, it's Harriet Kemsley.
Yeah.
It says here, as part of a challenge for a TV show, Harriet once appeared on Babe Station. That's where I know you from. What was the challenge on Babe Station? What did you do?
You had to, like, be sexy on camera. So I was like, ooh. I didn't really know what to do, and we didn't get much money.
Who was we? Who else was
that? Well, my husband did it as well. I think that was the big... that's what people really didn't like. In fact, people were quite angry. We got a lot of complaints.
Alan, OK, it says here you're related to one of tonight's guests. Is that true?
Yes. It's Jonathan Ross. We are related.
Yeah, but I've asked you so many times not to tell people.
You won't be so offended when you're looking for a relative for a kidney.
Yeah. But, yes, we are. But we're fairly close relatives,
yeah, we
aren't
are. We are.
So weird.
Yeah, yeah.
What are you?
What?
Brothers.
Brothers. Yes, brothers. We are brothers. But the great thing is, because you're a little bit older than me, when I found out Jonathan Ross was related to me, it was like finding out you had an extra nana.
Yeah. He keeps asking me about the will. He's not in it.
How are you related? What's the actual...
It's about three, four grandparents back, isn't it? The BBC had asked me for ages to do this Who Do You Think You Are, and I kept saying no, no, no. Then I saw the one with Chris Akabusi, and he ended up in Trinidad and Tobago. I thought, Alan, put your name down. Trilogy. Peckham. 2 weeks in Peckham.
Alan found out because one of your relatives had been a deserter in the war as well.
I know, yes, he ran off dressed as a woman. They told me this at the Imperial War Museum.
Oh, no.
How much of an arsehole did I It's about the Battle of the Somme, yeah, because he ran off in slingbacks and a woman's axe.
Harriet, now, Harriet, congratulations are in order. You just had your first baby. How are you finding parenthood?
Thank you. Yeah, it's good. I had the baby at St. Thomas's in London, and they take the baby security, like, very seriously. So, like, you have the baby and then you have to show them the car seat that you're going to take the baby home in. And so they were like, have you got the car seat? And they have to look at it and you have to show them it. But the problem is me and my husband never got a car seat, so the baby's still there. she's in the best place, and women can't have it all. So she's being looked after and I'm here tonight, so... Thank you, St. Thomas's, for everything.
A
OK.
Maisie, it says here your family WhatsApp group is very active. What do you think they'll be messaging about tonight?
My mum always wants to know, if I get to do a telly thing like this, she always wants to know if people are nice and then how tall they are. every single time. So I imagine when I finish this, I'll have a message saying, Jonathan Ross seemed nice, about 5'10" to me. Am I right? Lots of love. And then there's always loads of emojis as well. So they'll probably be like, 6 love arts, 5 clocks, 3 pens and papers.
And for me, at least one aubergine, I hope.
An aubergine. Probably that. And I'll reply, yeah, about 6 foot, actually, mum, and he was a total dickhead.
Surprisingly tall, is our
Surprisingly
Jonathan.
Tall.
I used to be taller. I used to be 6'1½. Now I'm 6½. I've lost an inch. Yeah. Although, I think I want to know where it went, because my balls are a lot lower than they used to be.
Jonathan, you're a vegan now. How's that going?
I've been vegan now for about a year. And you know what? I love it. It's great. I live mainly off of a sort of nourishment pea drink.
What?
You're drinking your own pee?
No. there's this thing called Huel, which is this fast food type thing.
It's just like gruel.
What do you mean it's like gruel?
it's like disgusting.
Have you tried the cinnamon swirl?
No.
Have you tried the coffee cream latte?
Do you work for Huel?
Yes, I'm hoping to.
It feels to me like, Jonathan, I mean, just reading between the lines here, but it feels like you're no longer on solid food because you're at that age.
You're joking, but in a way, there's something that is... This is going to sound depressing, but I've got to the age where I've kind of eaten enough.
Oh, my God!
I'm like an elephant wandering off to die. Did you bring a mascot, Jonathan?
Sorry, I forgot where I was for a minute. yes, Jimmy, I bought a mascot. Here's an idea I had, which I think, I hope, will catch on. As you know, I like more flamboyant clothes and dress sense. It won't surprise you. Being a fan of Magnum PI, I have a lot of Hawaii shirts at home.
Beautiful.
So I've come up with the British version of the Hawaiian shirt.
Okay? Ooh.
This is the British shirt, and this is decorated, and I think you'll find this will speak to you. So let me stand up and show you. So you see, it's a suitably grey colour to match the weather most of the time, and it's got scenes in it. There, for example, is a classic traditional scene of the Friday night fight outside of Wetherspoons.
Oh, that's beautiful.
And there's the Alsatians have come in and the boys are going at it. Here we have a surfer, which I know sounds Hawaiian to you, but he's like a UK surfer. As you can see, there's lots of fecal matter and used condoms on the surfboard from our lovely waterways. But down the bottom here, you've got the classic picture of the teenagers smoking cider and drinking some dank weed.
Dank weed?
I think they're probably smoking the dank weed and drinking the cider.
I reckon I'll say. I mean, if they're anything like me, they put it into a fluid anyway and just have it on.
Jonathan Ross, everyone.
Thank you.
Amazing.
Yes.
Have you got a mascot? What did you bring?
What can really help sometimes to give a good performance, and they've been quite popular, shared on social media fairly recently, is a good old motivational quote. Like, my friend's mum has them a lot round the house. They say things like, if you want the rainbow, you've got to put up with the rain. She's got written across her kitchen wall, you don't have to lick the spoon, but it helps. We don't know what that one means. So, I have created a motivator generator, OK?
This is perfect.
Most of the best, like, inspirational quotes, like the ones I've just said, they're sort of in two parts, OK? So I'm going to sort of invent our own motivational quotes that are going to help us score.
Great, let's go.
Should we get our first
one? Let's get the first half.
OK, so we've got the only thing worse than failure...
All right.
Good start. Ooh,
that's deep.
Start.
That's deep. ..is learning to dance in the rain.
Okay,
so let's say Jonathan's having a bit of a mare, he can't work out with the numbers or something, and I say, Jonathan, if at first you don't succeed... If at first you don't succeed, be a pink flamingo.
Explains the trousers.
Yeah.
On one leg.
You're halfway there.
Harriet, have you got a mascot?
I do have a mascot. As I said earlier, I had a baby. And me and the baby have got quite a lot in common in that we both really like to cry for no reason. It's really fun for my husband. So what I did is, because I don't know if you guys know this, but when a baby cries, it doesn't make a very nice sound. So I invented the baby no cry headphones. So when a baby cries, the headphones make the cry into a nice noise. so that the bad noise becomes a good noise.
Right, OK.
OK, can we play some baby crying?
OK.
Good, yeah, not too loudly, otherwise my boobs are going to leak all over Alan. OK. Watch out, Alan. So you're playing the baby crying, and then it's going to convert it into something that I want to hear. You guys hear a baby crying, but I hear my dad unknowingly eat a vegan sausage and say, "This is the best sausage I've ever had." You hear a baby crying, but I hear Rachel Riley tell me that she's quite intimidated by my intellect. You hear a baby crying, but I hear the sound of cunnilingus. That is not as nice as I thought that would sound, actually. Do you want to listen to that?
No, I don't.
It's not very nice.
I imagine it sounds like, you know, when you lick, try and lick out the fruit from a fruit corner.
Yeah, it's just like that, yeah.
Okay, I might give it a go.
I'm sorry.
Alan, did you bring a mascot?
Yeah, I did. I went a bit old school, so I brought a little teddy bear along.
What's happened? Ooh,
well, do you know I've gone for a really spiteful, messy divorce?
Oh, and, sorry, and I'm very sorry to hear
it. My ex's lawyer said, take half of everything. Look
at
that.
Oh, no.
That, but not just that. Household items, look at that, half a kettle. Why would you do that? Half a kettle, half a toaster.
Oh,
half a fondue set. Look at that, all the cheese goes over the floor. And obviously, you know, people want to know about, you know, we've divvied up my celebrity friends. I get custody of Adele.
Yes. Good.
Paul gets gawk at the weekend. We're still friends, and I know he's taken half everything, but you know what? The one thing he can't take is my dignity. Yeah. Am I right?
Yeah.
Thank you. I sat on a Twix.
Am I going to be looking at your arse cheek for the whole show?
I know.
Do you have the other leg?
Yeah, I've got another leg. I could put the other leg on. Or I could just put on some normal trousers. Instead of just trying to get a cheap laugh.
Over in Dictionary Corner, it's Huge Davies. Mm. Yeah. Huge has been on the show before. We wanted him back because we love his infectious energy and enthusiasm. Huge, I feel compelled to ask, is there a reason you're dressed as Father Christmas?
I know you bring that up. The producers said I was doing the Christmas special in 2021, and then they said that that's a terrible idea, you bring a negative vibe. And then I said, well, I can't be bothered to change any of my material. And so here we are.
So, sorry, so this is... You're going to do tonight stuff you wrote for a Christmas special over a year ago?
I don't see why not. Don't look at me like that. I'm your fucking tailor.
And with Huge, of course, it's everyone's favourite, Susie Dent!
Yeah! Yeah.
Fun fact... You can ask Alexa what Susie Dent's word of the day is, and Alexa will automatically call the Samaritans for you. Susie, obviously language is always evolving. Have you got examples of things that used to have different names?
Yes, I'll give you a couple of my favourites, because words do evolve, they change, just as humans change, you know, used to have hairlines and human teeth and that kind of thing.
Susie!
I like it.
Come on.
So, penguins used to be called arse feet.
That is a better name for them,
isn't
it?
Arse feet.
I don't mean they'd sell the biscuits as much, would they?
And in charge of the numbers, it's Rachel Riley. Rachel is multi-talented, whether it's sticking letters on a board, taking letters down from a board, or standing near a board. She can do it all. Rachel, as being a parent taught you anything? You've got two kids now.
I'm learning some good life hacks from the toddler.
Go on.
You're in a room or you're in somewhere you don't want to be. You can say you need to go and fetch something that's clearly not going to be in there. So the weirdest thing that she's requested when she's going to bed has been a bowl of cheese, some goggles and a pineapple. And another one is if you don't want to do something like, you know, saying thank you or cuddling someone goodbye, you can say you're shy. So the next time you put one of your weird requests in, I'm just going to say I'm shy and go and get some goggles.
If you've been shy, you wouldn't have those two babies, so... OK, the prize the teams will be competing for tonight is this, the Countdown Clogs.
Of Jonathan's drinks.
Yeah. I found that strangely moving.
Okay, right, let's count down, everyone. Time for the first game. Jonathan, Maisie, you get the first pick of the letters.
Oh, the pressure. Okay, a vowel, please.
E.
A consonant.
L.
A vowel. A vowel.
A.
A consonant.
T.
Consonant, please.
R.
Consonant.
K.
Consonant.
T.
Vowel.
And the last one, E.
Your time starts now. Jonathan, how many letters?
I'll go with the 7.
Go, OK. Maisie, how many?
I've got 6.
OK. Alan, how many?
I've got 6.
OK, and Harriet?
I've got 6, but it could be 7 if I put another letter in front, but then I don't think it's a word, so 6.
What's your 6, Harriet?
I've got a letter.
OK, what was your 7?
Cletter. I think it was the clogs. It made me think that maybe, like, you could do something with that, like, cletter, clogs.
Susie, clatter, is clatter a word?
No, but clatter shoe is. So maybe you were going towards that, which is a light boot with a felt sole worn for rock climbing.
A bit like a clog.
A bit like a clog, but made of felt.
So sort of the opposite of a clog. Maisie, you're 6?
Relate.
Very good.
Alan, you're 6?
Kettle.
Jonathan, you're 7.
And I'm not convinced I'm right, but kettler.
It's not there. Oh, I'm sorry.
Well, 6 points to both teams. Huge, Susie. Could they have done any better?
8. So you could have tolerate.
OK. On to our first numbers round. Alan, Harriet, your turn to pick the numbers.
Wait, I forgot how this goes. Wait, what do you do? You pick an even one.
yeah, go on. Yeah, just do it as you remember. It's fine. You just...
An even one, a couple with 2. A naught on the end. 100, that's
2,
good.
100.
1,000.
50.
And then more 2s.
So we're going to have an 8. That's a few 2s.
That's what it is. Small and then big.
4,
that's what it is.
A couple of 2s.
Yep.
And another 4. There we go. Loads of 2s for you.
OK, and your target is?
And the target.
Oh, no. No one's hoping for miracles, Harriet.
Oh, God.
727.
727. Your time starts now. So the target was 727. Alan, did you get it?
Oh, I think I've got 732.
Jonathan, did you get it?
I've got 800.
Maisie?
I'm
732.
Harriet, did you get it?
I got 726.
Oh.
Wow.
Wow, that's amazing. Cool.
That is incredible.
OK, so 8 times 100, then you get 800.
8 times 100. Yes, it's 800.
And then if you have 8 times 8...
You've used your 8.
No, no, because fours. You add the 4 and the 4. Two Thank fours. You, Jonathan.
Well, that gives you 1 8.
Oh. You've used that.
Fuck.
Alan, how did you get 732?
100 times 8, that's 800.
Yep.
And then I take the 50 off, and then the 4 times 4 is 16, take that off, and then I took the other two off.
So 734, 732.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well,
okay.
Well,
Maisie,
yeah.
Is that how you
do
that?
That's what I did as well.
That's how Maisie did it as well. 7 points to both teams.
Oh. Yeah.
Rachel, this is the part of the show that creeps me out, where you do something weird with maths.
Well, I'm just trying to make you feel a bit more comfortable, and I just got to one away.
That's what I got to.
OK, Rachel, we'll come back to you. OK, both teams now have 13 points.
Wow.
And here is your teaser. The words are giant nip. The clue is put that on display. That's giant nip. Put that on display. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser. The words were giant nip. The clue was put that on display. It was, of course, painting. Yeah. So both teams have 13 points. Rachel Riley, 727 was what you were aiming at. Did you get it?
Yeah, I got it. If you say 50 plus 4 plus 4 is 58, times it by 100...
Right.
..for 5,800...
5,800. Well, you've massively overshot.
Divided by 8.
Divided by what?
8 for 725. Oh, and add on 2, hopefully.
I mean, that's insane. Rachel Riley, everyone. OK, they've been playing in teams so far, but this game is just for Harriet and Jonathan.
Uh-oh.
So, Harriet, your turn to choose.
5 vowels and...
5 vowels?
Quite and a lot. 7 consonants.
So maybe 4 vowels, four. 5 consonants?
Yes.
I think that would be good. That'd be pretty good.
Thank you. Thank you, Rachel. I do appreciate it.
S, P and...
Is that all right?
W and a C.
As the clock's going, I might do my last 30 seconds of community service. Your time starts now. Hey, what are you doing? Fucking bell end. What are you doing? Really? Really? I think you've won, but this bin juice is actually delicious. Harriet, how many?
4.
4. Jonathan, how many?
6.
6. Harriet, what's your 4?
Crap.
It's hard to say this without it sounding weird, but can you pull me off? Thanks. Oh. If you could just... Yeah, no, I like it. Ooh. Jonathan, what was your 6?
I've got wipers.
Wipers.
Oh, wow. Or swiper.
Very good.
OK, 6 points to Jonathan.
Nice one, Jonathan.
Pretty good. Huge. Susie, could they have done any better?
We've got saucier.
And spacier.
Oh. OK, right, now time for Maisie and Alan to go head-to-head. Maisie, your turn to pick the numbers.
One big one, please. 3 small ones. Another big one.
Yep.
Small.
Nice choice.
Thank you, Rachel.
4 little. 3.
Gee, that nice choice.
1.
What, 7. What's a nice choice?
Do you 8. Know why? Because I'm being a pink flamingo about this.
175. And your target, 998.
Oh, for God's
sake. Oh, that's...
OK, and your time starts now.
Oh, God.
Thank you. OK, so the target was 998. Alan?
I've got 999.
One away, really OK. Maisie?
Got 1,001.
So you're a little bit closer, Alan, so tell us how you did it.
OK, 3 plus 7 is 10.
3 plus 7, 10.
And then times it by 100, that's 1,000, isn't it?
Yeah, 1,000.
And then you just take the one off.
Yeah. Oh.
7 points to Alan. Rachel, could it be done?
So 3 plus 7 is 10, but then 100 minus 1 is 99. Times those together for 990 and add on the 8. 998.
Wow. OK, time now to go across the literary corner. Huge. Is this song going to be about Christmas?
Yeah. And what else? As I said, I was meant to originally do the Christmas song in 2021 in December, but hopefully it will still make sense. So here we go. 2021 is almost over, thank God, and I can't wait for the next year. 2022 is finally here. Got my dad a present, yeah, we're off on a trip to Australia to see Djokovic. You've had both the jabs, then I'm straight to Vegas, which I've saved up for months, cause I am taking my mum to see Adele. Boy, I bet it goes well. 2021 is almost over, thank God. Oh, look at the turkey! 2022 is finally here. Spent all my money on that tennis match. I really hope that the price of gas stays exactly the same. Because after 2 years of loss and desperation, I just feel that Pune's gonna make a statement. Just relax and have a really chill time. 2021 is almost over, thank God, and we've got nothing to fear. Stop crying, Jimmy. 2022 is finally here. I've got a big day in court. I hope it will be sorted. I'm feeling tense and quite depressed. I work in Woking Pizza Express. 2021 is almost over, thank God. Hope Will Smith gets that Oscar, rooting for him. 2021 is finally here. And if it's going badly, well, let's just watch a film to cheer us all up next year. Oh, look, the Batman's out. I hope it takes a lighter tone.
Your teaser, the words are a dim ring, the clue is I can't stop looking at it. That's a dim ring, I can't stop looking at it. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the tease, the words were a dim ring. The clue was, I can't stop looking at it. It was, of course, admiring.
Ah.
OK, before we go on, time for a quick bonus round. So far, we've tested the maths and English skills of our players, but now it's time to test their tongues.
Is Alan going to do the yoghurt pot thing?
And if you aren't.
Everyone, please join me in the middle for Who's Drinking the Disgusting Drink? Oh. Please.
Wow. I've got nice legs, I think. Do you think? Who's fancying turkey drumsticks? Go on.
Oh, what's interesting is, though, he's only shaved one of his balls.
Harriet.
Yes.
OK, pay close attention. Alan, Maisie and Jonathan have a series of drinks in front of them. Two of them will be drinking something delicious. One of them will be drinking something disgusting. It's your job, Harriet, to work out who's drinking the disgusting drink.
So we have to pretend they're disgusting even if they're not?
Yes.
And if it is disgusting, allow it to be seen that it's disgusting?
Whatever your strategy would be.
But... Jonathan, as well, if you want a wretch, just have a look down at my ball bag.
I've seen a lot worse. OK.
There are 5 points at stake, so let's play Who's Drinking the Disgusting Drink? OK, the first drink, it's a delicious cider for two of you, but for one of you, it's vinegar. Have a sniff of the delicious cider and or vinegar. So, swigs, please. Who's drinking the delicious drink? Who's drinking the awful vinegar?
I would drink all mine. It was so nice.
So who are you thinking has got the nice drinks, then?
OK, well, I think Jonathan's got the nice drink, cos he keeps going, mmm, it's so nice. But he could be bluffing.
Am I bluffing? Or is it lovely?
Yeah, could you drink more of it, please?
No.
Who do you think's got the disgusting drink? What's your
I
early guess?
I think Alan looks quite sad.
He's just gone through a divorce.
Half the bloody trouser leg on.
Maisie's eyes went a funny colour, which I think is hard to act.
Community theatre.
Yeah, so we'll
3 years.
What did you get in the degree? Did you get a first or...?
No, I got a 2-1, thank you. It was a really well-respected degree. You had to have 2 GCSEs to do it, and they didn't care what the grades were.
Not any level insight. OK, let's try another one. Now, two of our lovely contestants have a tasty hot chocolate, but for one of them, it's a blend of blue cheese, horseradish and garlic mayonnaise. Oh. Okay, so
I'll stick with the vinegar. I'm fine.
We'll have a little drink. Little drink,
but I really like garlic mayonnaise, don't you?
It's got it on. You got your lip, Alan.
Okay, it's. You've got a moustache now. You've got a moustache and it really suited you.
Sorry, sorry.
Maisie's having a bad time, but I don't know if it's the GCSE.
It's a degree, but we'll let that go because I genuinely think it should be worth a GCSE. So, one more. This is a lovely, healthy smoothie for two of you, but one of you will be drinking a generous helping of mackerel. Yummy.
Oh, my.
Yummy mackerel. I want to see the level go down. I have a good bell to this. Oh, Alan's gone for it. Alan's gone for it. Maisie's gone for it. Jonathan? OK, we need your answer now. Who's been drinking the disgusting drinks? Who do you think? It's 5 points for you if you get it right.
Am I allowed to let one of them make one of them down it?
You can get one of them to try another drink, yeah.
Just have a little more sip of that mackerel.
You know what? I could drink all that because it's fruit.
Please do.
Why are you wasting your chances on
this? Just go ahead. Just drink it. Big sip.
No, no, it's fine.
Yeah, nice big sip. No, that was a tiny sip.
That was nothing.
We need a fucking tiny bit. It's fine, it's fruit juice.
Yeah.
All right, we need an answer.
Jonathan.
Who's drinking? Jonathan's drinking the disgusting drinks.
No!
No!
Mine are delicious!
Double black!
Who's, okay, it's for Harriet. Harriet. Okay, so you've not got the points, but just who do you think then had the disgusting drinks?
Alan.
It's cider.
Maisie!
I feel physically sick.
The points go to Maisie. 5 points for Maisie. You fooled her. Everyone back to your seats.
That one.
You won one on that one.
Jonathan? I don't think of you as an actor, but you nailed that. What was your little secret there?
I played you like a fiddle because you were looking at me and first of all you got it right and then I thought, okay, I'm going to pretend that I'm acting to enjoy it even though I was really enjoying it.
And then Alan, just like now and again, he just like, I don't think you knew what was happening.
No.
No.
And then you'd have this dig like there's a sadness about you, like you're some bitchy clairvoyant.
And Maisie, I mean, it turns out that your, frankly, Mickey Mouse acting degree really paid off.
Well, I didn't think I was acting. That was genuinely vile.
You had tears in your eyes at one point.
I think I was crying vinegar.
Yeah. Was that not a clue that she was drinking the disgusting drinks?
I thought it was the acting.
They don't teach you vinegar tears.
You got 5 points. You did very well. You're now in the lead.
You did amazing.
Maisie, I don't know.
You really took three for the team.
OK, on with the game. Jonathan, Maisie, your turn to choose the letters.
Consonant vowel, consonant vowel, consonant vowel.
T, I, oh, God. M, A, L.
I think the mackerel's back.
Oh, my. Oh. Oh, that was...
Oh, wow. Oh, it just hit me.
Oh.
Wow.
I've never been so panicked.
Give us another vowel, please.
I.
And give us another consonant. Another vowel.
E.
Let's have another consonant.
And B.
Okay, and your time starts now. Okay, Jonathan, how many letters?
Six.
Okay, Maisie, how many?
Six.
Alan?
Seven.
Oh. Harriet?
Seven. I'm just going to go for it.
Maisie, what was your six?
Animal.
Right.
Oh. Don't ask me too much, because I don't feel very capable of speaking at the moment.
Okay, that'll be... That's the mackerel repeating on you.
Don't say mackerel. How are you spelling animal, Ray? In French.
So, Jonathan, you're six.
Entail.
Ooh.
Oh, that's a clever one.
Very nice. Harriet, let's do your seven because, you know, get it out of the way.
So, I've got two different
two,
sevens.
Two different sevens.
Two different sevens, wow.
So...
What do you mean, wow? They won't be real words. Where's the wow
we
in this?
We don't know they're not real words.
I'm giving you the benefit of the doubt.
Thank you. Betamol.
Betamol?
Well, I'm losing hope.
Betamol.
Or Lemoneb.
Excuse me, Doctor, I'm having a problem with my laminate.
Exactly, yes, exactly.
Is that nonsense word in there?
No.
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 Will you be involving in the homeschooling of your child?
We've got to hope there's not another pandemic. It's fucked. Okay.
Alan, you're seven.
Ailment.
Oh. Oh.
God. 7 points for Alan. Back in the lead. Huge. Susie, could they have done any better?
Imitable.
And what does imitable mean?
Imitable means copyable or imitatable.
Imitable means copyable or imitatable. Sorry, Susie.
That's all right. It's the mackerel.
You OK?
Yeah.
Is there going to be another burp?
No. Can I motivate myself for a bit?
Yeah, I think you should motivate yourself, because I'll be honest with you, those drinks are going through you like shit through a goose.
Are we still going out for those tandoori prawns later?
Oh. Life's not about waiting for the storm to pass. Come on, Maisie. It's 5 o'clock somewhere.
Right. Yeah. OK. Time to go across the dictionary corner once again. Huge. Your second time on Countdown. How did it go down when people saw you on the show the first time?
Yeah, I spoke to my dad about it. Unfortunately, there is no chemistry between us. So I've had to just put it to music to make it seem as if it's sort of fun. So it went a bit like this. Hi, Dad, nice to see you again. Yeah, right, sure, yeah. Did you see I was on a Countdown? I thought it quite well. That's not what Twitter was saying. Tell you what. You used to watch Countdown in the day. Did you like it? Did I like it? Oh. I'm not really sure I understood what the fuck was going on. Why is there a mascot bit? Why was there half an hour of it? I didn't really understand why no one on was good at Countdown. At one point, someone got five letters and everybody fucking cheered. Then halfway through, you came on, randomly just did a song. And why'd that song have to be being kidnapped as a child and put in a van and bound in gangs and put in a bag by a horrible man? And why was it me? It clashed with the numbers round tonally. Dad, it doesn't sound like you did really like it. Honestly, I just appreciated it. If you didn't really like it, you just kept it to yourself. Oh, I didn't really understand what the fucking fuck was going on. Why can't you get on Jonathan Ross or Alan Carr, get a real job? I also didn't really understand why Carol looked so young. I said, Dad, I also didn't really understand what the fuck was going on. At the gates, they thought I was Phil Wang. And they kind of just let me on.
Phil Wang, everyone! And here is your final teaser. The words are ooh, ah, missus, and the clue is give it a good clean. That's ooh, ah, missus, give it a good clean. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the tease. The words were ooh, ah, missus. The clue is give it a good clean. It was, of course, washroom. Time for our final letters game. Alan, Harry, your turn to choose.
All right.
Great. You choose this time.
Because... I think, yes, yeah. I think we all want to get home. consonant. Oh. Vowel. Wow.
Wow.
That's now what I want.
This. That's the stage of the evening. Yeah. Come on.
I'm on a roll.
That was sexy, actually.
E, T, I, and U.
Are you 30 seconds starts now. Okay. Okay. Yeah, I see. You've actually taken away too much. I've restored a painting, look at that. Nice, isn't it?
Oh, wow.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Ooh, that nearly brought the mackerel back up.
Right. Maisie, how many?
It's harrowing, that. I've got an 8.
Wow.
Jonathan.
I think I might have a 7.
Excellent news. Alan.
I've got 5.
OK. Harriet.
You know what? It's just been nice to get out of the house. Have you ever had anyone not get... anything before?
Yeah, you've been on the show before. And that's when it last happened. Alan, you're 5?
Well, I think I've got a 6 now, but
oh.
I mean...
Oh, well, go on, then.
OK. Untile, like, you know, when you put tiles up in a bathroom and then if you take the tiles off, you untile. Is that a word, Susan?
No, it's not, Alan, I'm afraid.
Oh. I like the way she pretended to even look in the dictionary.
Yes. No, it's not here. Untile.
Jonathan, you're 7.
It's untithe.
Untithe?
Untithe. Untithe.
U-N-T-I-T-H-E.
Old school.
Not there.
Not in there, OK. Oh, Maisie. OK,
right.
So go on.
So, as I say, remember what I've done in the last round?
Sure.
I've had a drink that's been mixed up like the ones you've been drinking. It had a fish in it.
Not good.
Maybe it would have been a tuna hule.
Tuna hule.
Tuna hule.
Annoyingly, it's not up there.
A tuna hule?
You've used the U how many times?
Well, as I say, I often have the French version.
It's the German version now.
OK. That is no points to anyone. Susie, was there anything there?
Not a lot, no. We had auntie and talent.
So... OK, so Jonathan and Maisie have 24 still, and Alan and Harriet have 27.
Oh, wow.
Okay, it's a crucial conundrum today. Are you ready for this?
Yeah.
Okay, have you got your buzzers?
Yeah.
Buzzers.
Wait. Oh, yeah, yeah.
I don't have a buzzer.
I don't think you're going to use it, are you?
I tell you what, if you get it, just go buzz. Okay, fingers on buzzers. Time for today's crucial countdown conundrum. Time starts now.
Buzz.
Stop the clock.
Buzz.
Stop the clock. Alan, buzz. Alan, buzz. Go on. Yes.
No, I just wanted to see if you respected me enough to stop.
for a second there, we all thought, a miracle.
Yeah. That would have been such a lovely end to the show.
I know, it would have been so nice.
The clock starts again. Okay. Yeah. Time starts now. Alan! Oh.
Dangerous.
Oh. Yes.
Let's have a look and see if you're right, Alan Carr, for the win.
Yes. He's right! Yes.
Scores are Jonathan and Maisie have 24, but Alan and Harry have done it with 37 points. Congratulations, Alan and Harry. You'll know the proud owner of these Countdown clogs. Thanks to all our panelists, our wonderful studio audience, and to all of you for watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.
It's the end of the world. No, it's not, because you can stream series 1 and 2, That's the Lot, available right now on all 4. But coming up, OKing It Like Only They Know How, The Last Leg Lads with Alice Tye and James Acaster.